first criteria is that it manages our human waste safely. I think what's happening here is that people are generally using a pit-based toilet. The toilet is in a hole in the ground, and then there's, you know, just basically when the hole gets filled up or whatever, we just move the thing around. We've now got a mixed fecal content in the water supply. The two things are mixed up together, and it's quite difficult to unmix them. They really need to be separate, right? Like the waste stream, we need to capture, because there's also nutrients in the waste. Right, there's nutrients. I mean, human beings spend a lot of money sticking stuff in this end, right? It's cost. There's nutrients. There's a lot of waste nutrients that come out the other end.
Seven.
Because it's a permanent structure, it can actually support more than just the toilet. So we don't have to think of, well, there's a toilet, that thing stands on its own. But there's linkages. What's happening between that toilet and the immediate environment? There's this bottom chamber with two toilets, right? Now, it's where a household or a school or whatever is managing their waste. We could build that for actually managing other solid waste recycling in the same facility. And I thought that next to these composting toilets there's quite a nice space to build some storage containers where it could all be concentrated, kept in one place. If very simply linked the waste stream to tree planting at a domestic level, so that I could plant any other useful tree into the environment which I enjoy. There's lots of forest here. There's not a lot of trees around in the village. I think there's an opportunity to grow a few more of useful ones. I mean, there's technically for sanitation just one other element, then one links up a few of those elements and links them together in an ecological cycle. The productivity of that system increases. So there's just yield out, greater yield out of good design, not necessarily that I have to. In fact, if it's good design, I should put in less effort. I'm imagining that those toilets should last for 100 years.